Then we discussed about the conversions, how one flip-flop can be used as other flip-flop, right? So that we needed to add one combinational circuits that is called the next state generating function. So the circuit will be designed in such a way that that will force the flip-flop input into into such a way that that will perform as another flip-flop for which the combinational circuit was designed. Then further we continued our discussion just to add one more stage of combinational circuits at the output, so that the circuit can be used for any application, right? Any application in the sense any real time requirements, because we have two kind of controls other than the memory. One is the first combinational circuits, another one is the output combinational circuits, right? So with the help of the first combinational circuits called the next state generating function, and then the last combinational circuit called the output generating function, and with one memory unit, it is possible to realize the sequential circuit for any kind of applications, right? Because you take any application that requires memory is nothing but your flip-flop, right? And then you need some combination circuit input which will decide what should be the next state of your memory, output of your memory, and then based on the logical combination of the memory output and then present input, or sometimes only the memory output, some output will be generated now. So the idea here is if you look this diagram, the idea is something we are feeding here input, right? I'm feeding something input here, then the memory has already some bits. That means some bits are already stored either by reset or set. That means 1 and 0, basically. One flip-flop can store only one bit, right? So two flip-flop can store two bits, means four possibilities. So one flip-flop can store one bit means two possibilities. You can store either 0 or 1. So when you use two flip-flops in the memory, you can store two bits. That means four possibilities, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, and 1, 0, right? So the memory stored some value, memory possesses some value already, but this circuit will decide what should come out from the memory, right? That means memory should give you 1, or memory will give you 0, or memory will retain the 0, or will retain the 1. That will be decided by this circuit now. That is why this circuit is called a next state generating function, right? So with respect to this input and then the present state here, right, present state here. Present state means what is the current output of the memory with respect to this input and then actual external input. This circuit will decide what should be the next output of the memory. Next output of the memory, right? And then that memory goes into this output generating function. The input also goes there in the Mealy circuit. In the Mori circuit, this input will not go there, right? So this circuit will generate the required output here. You see now, I have some combinational circuit such a way that I can drive the record memory. Then already memory possesses some value, thus the respective value will be brought out here. Then that will go into one more combinational circuit. That combinational circuits will do the necessary output, will give you the expected output, because the memory unit output may not be in the form of your expectation, because we needed to control something, we needed to drive something. Understand now, or you needed to bias some voltage level now. So this memory unit can give you some input, some outputs here. Maybe 0 will maintain as 0, or 0 will be converted into 1, or 1 will be converted into 0, or 1 will be maintained 1 now. So if you have two flip-flops here, you will get the 4 possibility of output at this point. That possibility may not be directly injected into your output unit, cannot be brought out directly into your output unit. So you needed to have some more manipulation or some more modification, some more processing there. Therefore, we should have one more combinational circuit, say. So these combinational circuits will map the memory output, right, memory output and also the input function such a way that is useful to directly apply into your external output now, because all those things are inside the FPGA. Right, everything is inside FPGA now. This is your FPGA. That means the external input is coming from the external world. This is the external input. The clock also will come from the external world, right? And then this output goes into the external world now. remaining everything is happening inside the chip, inside that chip, inside the FPGA now, right? So all this internal feedback, routing, wiring, channeling, everything happens inside the FPGA now. Therefore, with the help of these combinational circuits, these two combinational circuits and one memory unit, it is possible to design the sequential circuits for any kind of application. So this what we called general structure or block diagram of sequential circuits. Block diagram or general structure. General structure of sequential circuits. Synchronous sequential, not asynchronous, synchronous sequential circuit. Synchronous in the sense the control, all the control will be with respect to clock here. Right? It is everything is with respect to clock function now. So that means it is synchronized to something. Here it is nothing but a clock. Therefore, it is called a synchronous sequential circuits. Asynchronous sequential circuits mean there is no clock at all. So there is no any synchronization, there is no any control. That is why all those issues are coming into the picture. Races, critical race, hazards, right? All those things will be coming into the picture. We need to resolve all those things before going for the implementation in asynchronous sequential circuits. But in a synchronous sequential circuits, synchronous sequential circuit, SSC, the clock is the master control. So everything is in line with the clock, clock speed or clock phase. Okay, fine. Next, now, so therefore, how are we going to make use of these things for our applications? Now, we are going to see some real-time applications, right? Starting from bit recognition into vending machine control, then you will understand the significance of this kind of design, right? So, as I told you, the sequential circuits and then the combinational circuits, the both are essential for any real-time applications. You cannot meet all the applications only with the combinational or only with the sequential. You need to combine them together, right? So sometimes you need to go for Mori model, sometimes you need to go for Mille model, and some processes based on the FSM, some process based on some purely combinational or some multiplexer, shift register, encoder, right? So as we progress, your knowledge level will go up so that you can able to find out the logic for the given applications, right? So now, you keep in your mind, for any synchronous sequential circuits will require one combinational, then memory, then again combinational circuits, right? Now we are proceeding for one application, right? One sequential circuit design application, maybe design one. Design one, in this design, all the pens, no, over here. See, no pen is writing now. Design one. You listen me, clearly listen me. You should understand every point in this design. If you clearly understood it, then you apply the same thing for any kind of design. Right? There is no any difference. The algo should be clear to you. Once the algo is clear, then just you need to apply. Right? This is the FPGA. FPGA in the sense, in our point of view, it is a digital system, right? It is the digital system. X is one input, Y is the output now. This is the input.
So your voice was
block, FPGA block in the sense for us, it is the digital system, right? That means we are going to build some digital system inside the FPGA by top level programming. And this system has one input here, X, and one output here, Y. One output here, Y, right? So I'm telling you something like this. Suppose, if the sequence X is something like this, if the sequence is something like this, that means 1, 1, 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 1 1 0 1 1 1 1 0, something like that, right? That means I'm telling you, I needed to create one system here. The system should be capable of detecting particular sequence, right? Particular sequence. Then I'm writing here output now, y. The y is here, right? 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, right? 1, 1, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, right? Shall I repeat now? Can you able to see clearly these things? Okay. Now, I'm asking you to design the digital system to generate this output for this X, for this input. Understand, no? For this Y, you design the digital system to generate this Y for the given X, for the given X now, right? That means, what you understand from here, you look the input and output, the output is here high, and the output is here high, and then again here high, and then here again high, and then again here high. Correct, no? Again here high now, right? And then remaining all the places it is zero. And sorry, one more, one, this is also one now. This is also one. Then one more one is here now. One more one is here now, right? If you carefully analyze this input and output relation, right? There are the FPGA, the digital system generates some output high. The output goes to high. Normally the output is zero and it goes to high, right? Again zero and it goes to high. Then you need to compare this output with the input when the output goes high. At what condition, at what circumstance the output goes high? In this example, we needed to think in such a way that, right, after receiving what kind of sequence the output goes high. After receiving what kind of sequence the output goes high, or that is our requirement here now. So if you look here, after receiving one, the output is a zero. Then I received another one, output is a zero. I received a zero, the output is zero. I received one, therefore the output goes to one now, right? Then again zero, zero. So it appears something like that. If this 1 0 1 1 1 1 0 1 is received, then the output goes high. It appears something like that right now. It appears something like this. Correct, no? That means we can able to make out by observing the first output. The output goes to high in this digital system after receiving 1 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 now. But we cannot confirm now. We cannot confirm right now because we needed to again and again check the same profile. If the circuit is generating the output for the same kind of profile, then we can ensure that this circuit is written to detect this particular sequence, right? Because this is very much essential when you go for your multiple data transmission or reception system. It is something like that. Your FPGA is here, your system is here, your receiver is here. There is a transmitter 1 and one more transmitter 2 and another transmitter 3, for example, and so on, transmitter n, right? So all the transmitters will send you the data to this receiver. This receiver should understand that this data is coming from this transmitter alone, or the data that is arriving at that instant of time is corresponding to this transmitter now. So what happened? Every transmitter will send one unique code to the receiver. You understand now? So the receiver will check the unique code first of all, then followed by that unique code, then whatever the data is coming, that will be locked into the particular receiver, particular transmitter head now. So the sequence detector is very much essential in real-time application. So in sequence detector, it is also called a pilot sequence detector. Pilot sequence in the sense, first one pilot sequence will come, followed by the pilot sequence, your actual data will come. So receiver will understand that this data is belongs to this measurement. This is belongs to temperature 1. This is belongs to relative humidity. This is belongs to wind speed. this is belongs to pressure data, right? Because the receiver is sitting here, there is no any handshaking between transmitter and receiver. So the receiver should be able to understand only by looking the pilot sequence. So pilot sequence will always go first. It is like that, something like that. In aircraft, a pilot sits in front and drives, no? So something like that, your data bit will be like this. So first few bits will be for pilot sequence. Pilot sequence, and then pilot sequence, remaining these things will be your measurement data, or in general data. This is a data, this is a pilot bits, pilot byte or pilot bits now, right? So the pilot bit is the identity to the receiver. The receiver will first look at the pilot sequence. Then it will understand that this is belongs to this one, because it is already stored in the memory of the receiver now, right? So bit sequence, pilot sequence, bit recognition, sequence detector, sequence recognition is very much essential. It is there in most of the applications now, in order to make the receiver or recipient to understand that this is belongs to this guy, or this is belongs to this computer, this is belongs to this system, or this sensor, all those things, right? So right now our decision is 1101 is the valid sequence, because we got one output, one high one at this point now. Then you continue your analysis here. If I continue the analysis here now, again here one more one has come now. So this also evidence that 1101 is one now, right? 1101 is one here. So you cannot take that 01101, because here there is no any previously zero, but we got output one here. Therefore now we confirmed 20% we confirmed that this circuit should be to detect this 1101 sequence, 1101 sequence. So this analysis over, this analysis over, and then you continue, and then you continue here again. Here also one is here, here also one is here. So if you go back to the transmitter bits, then 1011, so this guy also confirms that 101101 is the actual sequence. 101101 is the actual sequence, because we got 11 here also. Then after coming here, quickly you are getting one more one now, one more one here now, understand now? So this fellow confirms that either it may be the sequence of 101. You understand now? Because 101, because this is already over, 1101 is already over, so 101 is also there, right? So 101 is the sequence, then we should not get here also 101, here also 101, here also 101 is there, correct? No, 101 is there. Therefore now it gives one information that this bit may be for 101 also, maybe for 101 also now, maybe for 101 also, because 101 also the valid sequence as per the output concerned now, as per the output concerned. So we can take here this also may be for 101, and this also may be for 101, also may be for 101. Understand now? 101 possibility is there now, because every 101 you got the output, here also you got the output 101, understand? Then you continue here again, then one more one we got here, right? So this one shows that this 1101 also is there, right? 1101 also is there, right? At the same time 101 also is there, at the same time 101 also is there. One zero one also is there now, right? I'm adding one more bit here, I'm putting the zero here, I'm adding one more bit here and putting one zero here now, right? You add now 10, last I added a 11 and then 10, 10 now, right? Now look here, now we found a two bit. This circuit is for detecting either 110 1101 or 1101 or 1010, correct? No, as per the output input and output relation, we have detected two sequence. Now the circuit may be for 1101 or 101, correct? No, fine. Again, you continue your analysis now. See, we have here 101, but the output is a zero here, therefore this circuit is not definitely for 101, because there is a profile of 101, but the output generates, the corresponding output is here zero, correct? No, therefore this sequence is not for 101, because there is one 101, but its output is zero now. Therefore this circuit is definitely for 1101. Definitely for 1101. First point. First deduction by looking. Yes.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes, yes.
Before that 101, there is one also, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
Before that one is there, but this much data is given, you know. You have to analyze it. Your observation time is from here to here. That means if this kind of input is applied, then your system should generate this kind of output only. So last bit is 101, but you need 0 as the output. So therefore this circuit is not 101 detector. If it is 101 detector, then you should get 1 here. But 1 is not there. Yes.
Sir, in the last where the 101 is there, it means there 1101 is also there, sir.
Okay. You make this one 0. Correct, you are correct. You make this one 0. This one 0. I'm just rewriting now. You are correct. Just I won't tell you this idea. Okay, I will write now 0101. I shall change correctly. You are correct, yeah. 0101. Now this is the sequence given you. Any more questions on this, understanding this input-output relation? Okay. So now we confirmed that 101 is not the sequence. Therefore, we have to cancel this 101. So you also should analyze such a way that where the 1 is coming now. Then what is the actual sequence now, right? So we came to know that 1101 is the actual sequence to be detected now, right? So the first point is a sequence confirmation. We confirmed the sequence. Our sequence is here 1101. Next point is, the 1101s are separate 1101 or overlapped 1101. Separate 1101 or overlapped 1101, right? That we need to identify. Either it is a separate 1101 or overlapped 1101. Overlapped 1101 in the sense, you look here this is a 1101, it is a separate 1101, so we got one output here. Then you continue here also 1101, separate 1101, therefore we got one here. So it appears that it is a separate one. Then you come here, this is 1101, this is 1101, right? 1101, we got one here, understand? Then we got 101 here, so here also we got 1, therefore 101 is not the sequence. So it is taking from this one also, this one to this one, therefore this is the 1 now. So this one is considered for previous 1101, also the next 1101, therefore this circuit should follow the overlapped detection. I am explaining here 1101, then 101, so this is, here the output is 1, here also the output is 1, that means this 1 is shared for both. This one is shared for both. That means this one is considered for this 1101. Also, this one is considered for this 1101. Therefore, this circuit should be, this circuit should be overlapped detection. Overlapped detection, not separated detection. That means overlapping is allowed. Overlapping is allowed. Overlapped detection is required here. Overlapping should be allowed here. Understand now? Any doubt till now? Any doubt understanding this one? Maybe the question may be straight away, maybe like this also. 1101. Develop the Miele machine, develop the Miele model to detect the sequence 1101 with overlapping. With overlapping or without overlapping. With overlapping or without overlapping. Right. So this is a single petty detection. In the same way, there will be a double petty detection also. That we will see in the next example. Here only the one input. Only the one input and only the one output now. Only the one output. Did you understand this basic understanding of this pattern recognizer or pattern detection? Okay, fine. Next, now you understand from the given X and Y, it shows that this is the serial input and the serial output. First is 0, 1 is coming and then output should be 0. Next 1 bit will come because next this one is 0. So it is not the parallel input. So you cannot inject all these bits simultaneously into the system because it is serial system. Therefore, then first your B0 will come, then B1 will come, B2 will come and so on. B2 will come and then finally Bn minus 1 will come. So if you take this is your B0, this is your B0 and this is your Bn minus 1. Bn minus 1 now, right? Something like that. If you take this is your x naught and this will be your xn minus 1, xn minus 1. Okay, then if you take this is your y naught and this will be your yn minus 1, yn minus 1 now, right? So this much sequence is given here just to understand that this will be the pattern. This will be the output pattern for this input pattern. Therefore, from there we came to know that this fellow should detect 1101 now. Right, fine. So the first bit will come here. First bit will come here. Right. So the first bit may be valid bit or may not be the valid bit. So I'm going to draw the state diagram now. State diagram. State diagram. So this design is for Miele model. Miele machine. Miele machine or Miele FSM or Miele engine, all are same. Because machine is the very much essential, very important to control all the slave operations. State diagram. I am taking one state here. Suppose initially I am assuming yes not. S naught is the state, right? That means initially I assume that the memory unit is in S naught, because we know the general structure of our sequential circuits. The first is the input, combinational circuit, memory, right? Then your another combinational circuit, then finally our output now. So input is here, output is here. Inside, if you look inside, there are two combinational circuits and one sequential circuit. I mean one memory. Right, one flip-flop unit and one combinational circuits, one another combinational circuits, right? So that is a next state generating function, memory unit, and then your another output generating function. All those things will be there that we are going to derive now for this application. Okay, now S naught is there. If the first bit is zero, if the first bit is zero, then I no need to move anywhere. Because zero is according to me invalid bit. Zero is invalid bit. I no needed to do any operation inside the circuit because zero is not expected in the beginning, right? Zero is invalid bit, so I have to be in the same state. That means I no needed to change the state of the flip flop. You please understand. So nowadays we are seeing, no, they keep this mic close to their mouth. Yes, okay. Initially, this one, this bar, you know, oblique wala, uske upar wala represent the input, and niche wala represents the output, represents the output. This is in the Miele model. In the Moore is only 1, 3 inputs means again 0, 0, 1, 0, or maybe 3 inputs and 2 outputs, or 3 inputs or 1 output, right? So that we have to make out. How many inputs are there parallelly, how many inputs we needed to process it. That we will see as we progress. Fine. So what does it mean? S naught is here. So the memory should be in the flip-flop should be in the same state. There no need to make any changes because the input is 0, means it is the invalid input. Therefore, stay there and then generate the output 0. Generate the output 0. Right. Next point. Since it is the only one input, there are only two possibilities. Right. 0 may be the input or 1 may be the input. But if it is two inputs are there, then there are four possibilities. Then from S0 to you should go to 01 or 10 or 11 or 00 now, right? Such a way our state diagram will flow, right? So since only one input is here, as long as I am getting 0 as the input, then I have to stay here only now. Suppose if I am getting 1, then since the 1 is the valid input, since the 1 is the valid input, I should move into another state that I am representing here, S1. If 1 is coming, I should go there, but the output should be 0. Output should be 0 now, right? Look here. What does it mean? You know the general structure of your circuit. If you go here, so I'm telling now, if the input is a zero, output should be 0. Don't make any changes in the present state of the circuit. If the input is 1, then output should be 0, but you change the state means we are informing to the memory that memory transferred from one state into the another state means the circuit will understand that one valid bit is detected. Therefore, to indicate it, change your state to some other state now, but the output should be 0 only. The output should be changed. I mean, the state should be changed. Therefore, the input, because input is changed here, but output should not be changed. The output should be 0 only, but you change the state because input is changed now. So that is the meaning of this indication now. That means if one is coming, you move to another state, means you change your state to preserve that one is detected. One valid one is detected. We need to preserve that valid detection. So to preserve that valid detection means I have to move from one point to other point, then circuit will understand that one valid bit is detected now. Right? Because that is the input into the combinational circuit of output generating function. Also, this will indicate into the next state generating function of the first combinational circuits. Right. So in order to indicate to these two combinational circuits, one bit is detected, you change the memory should change its state to some other state such a way that these two will understand that one bit is detected. Right. Then you be here now in this state now. Understand now. So after coming to this state, if I detect a zero, so that means I detected a zero, therefore I'm here now. I detected one, therefore I detected one here, therefore I have come to this state now by generating the output 0, right? Because this one is a valid one, but output cannot be generated because I need to check for another few inputs. Okay, so 0, then after getting this one, if I get a 0 here, automatically this one becomes invalid. This one becomes invalid now. So we thought that one is valid, but after getting the second, because this is coming from somewhere, it is not in our hand now, right? So when 0 is coming, then this one becomes invalid. So I have to go back to this state because this one becomes now useless one, right? So if 0 is coming, go back to our S0, right? Generating the output to 0. Why we are going back to S0? Because I have come to S1 assuming that one from there the valid sequence may arrive, but it have not arrived now. Therefore, I am forcing the memory to go back to the previous state because that one is the invalid input. Then you have to start for your detection from the initial state. Initial state. Understand this one? Initial state. Next. Now, 0, therefore we went back to this one now. suppose I am getting one now. I am getting one now. Then this one is the really valid one. Therefore, I should go to S2 state. S2 state. If I get one here, but here also the output should be zero. Here also the output should be zero now, right? So that means for all possibilities of inputs in state S0, we have drawn the state diagram. That means we directed the circuit to go to stay in S0 or to move into S1. Then after coming to S1, we checked all the possibility inputs. Means if zero, then go back to S0. If it is one, go to the S2. Go to the S2, right? So if I am in S2, if I am in S2 means I detected two valid bits. Two valid bits, right? Two valid bits are detected. No, two valid bits are detected here. Therefore, I have come to the S2 now. So I changed the circuit also to the respective state to preserve that valid two detections. Valid two bit detections. Fine. Next, look here. Next, look here now. Suppose again if I am receiving one. Again, if I am receiving one, this one is a, see, if I receive one now, right? Now you assume next bit may be the valid bit. If I take this two, one is the valid sequence. So this one automatically becomes the invalid one. The first one, first detection, first one becomes the invalid one, and this two may be the valid one. So I have to stay back here only if I receive one by generating the output zero. I have to stay back here. Why should I stay back here now? Because now, if another bit also one, then see valid sequence may begin from this two one, no? Chances are there. If next bit is a zero, then this two is a valid one. Because our circuit should always aim for the 1 1 0 detection. Right? So because of this one becomes invalid one, but however, this one is valid and this one is valid. Therefore, I have to stay in the same state. I have to stay in the same state now. Suppose after detecting two ones from the when I am in S2, if I get to 1 1 1 1 0, then I have to go to S3. S3 state. So if I get a zero by giving zero as the output, I should go to the S3 state because 1 1 0 is the valid one now. So I have to stay here. If I get one, if I get a zero, I have to move into the S3. I have to move into the S3 state now, right? So if I come to S3 means I detected 1 1 0. Three valid bits are detected. Three valid sequences are detected. Correct or no? Fine. Then the fourth bit is, if the fourth bit is a zero, if the fourth bit is a zero, I detected a 1 1 0. If the fourth bit is zero, then all these detections are useless detection. All these detections are useless detection because this zero means a 1 0 0 is not the valid sequence here. So zero is detected, then output should be zero and go into the initial state. Because 1 1 0 is not the valid sequence, therefore you have to go back to the initial state. Force your memory to the initial state and start the detection as a fresh detection now. Understand? Suppose 1 0 1 0. Understand? 1 0 0 1 1. Sorry, 1 1 0 1 is coming. 1 1 0 1 is coming now. 1 1 0 1 is coming now. Right. So one. We received 1 0 1 is invalid detection. Invalid detection, correct. So 1 1 0 1 is detected. 1 1 0 1 is detected in the sense. 1 1 0 1 is detected in the sense. We have seen some overlapping here of one bit. Overlapping of one bit. Therefore, the one bit detection is here. So if you detect one here, then your output should be one and go into the S1. And go into the S1. I'm drawing with the other color. This means if you detect one, then you should go to S1. Why we should go to S1? Because here overlapping is allowed. One bit overlapping is allowed. In case if one bit our overlapping is not allowed here, then you should go to S0 only. You have to start from your initial detection only. Since here it is allowed, therefore we are going into S1. We are going into S1 by giving the output 1. By giving the output 1. Understand this state diagram? Any doubt in this state diagram? This is a very much essential state diagram. You should know how to draw the state diagram. By checking all the possibilities, you should be able to draw the state diagram. Okay, fine. Next, this is called a state diagram, Mealy model state diagram, Mealy FSM. Mealy FSM state diagram. Right. Next one is, next we needed to formulate the state table. We needed to formulate the state table. But they will tell you in the requirement, no, they will indicate to you 1 bit overlapping is allowed. But it is given you for from this sequence you came to know that it is for 1101 only, no? If it is not overlapped, it means 101 is not valid here, no? That we have come to know. Correct, you have here 1, then you have here 1. But at the end 101 is there, no? But for this 101, output is not 1. I'm not getting you. What is your question, Sal? By analyzing this Y, no, we came to know that it is not 101. It is only 1101. That is clear. Second thing is, 1 bit overlapping is here. Is it clear to you how one bit overlapping is here? Suppose overlapping is not there, means the sequence will not be like this, no? Output sequence will not be like this, no? Output sequence will be like this. Listen, I am writing here now. If suppose overlapping is not there, means I am writing now. This 1101 here, right? Then here 1101, only 1 will be here. This one will not come. Correct, no? This fellow will become 0 only. Have we understood, no? Okay. Right. Next.
So suppose that if the 1 is getting from the S3 side, it could go to S2 also.
If you get only one, it could go to S2 also. You are telling this one?
Yes, sir.
But if you go to S2, when will you go to S2? After receiving 2 ones only, no?
Okay, sir.
But here we received only 1, no?
Yes, sir.
Though we should go to S1 only.
Okay, sir.
Any more doubts? Please ask me.
Sir, when we get 1101 and then after 1-1, then the output is stuck at S2. What will then we do?
One second, tell me, after getting, we are
one,
getting
1101.
We got 1101.
And then after 1-1. After that 1-1 also is getting.
After that 1-1 is coming. Okay.
Yes, then the output is stuck at S2. How will get through it?
How it is, see, that means this is Ogaya, therefore you are here. You are getting 1, you are coming here, you are getting 1, you are coming here, no? That means it is not, it doesn't mean that you got stuck at 1-1, I mean S2. Anyway, you are going to get one more bit here. Who asked this question here?
Yes, sir. Aman, sir.
Aman, Sagar. Sagar, yes, you are going to get one more bit here, no?
Yes, sir.
And that bit will decide, you know, where you need to move.
So if that is 1, then it is also stuck at S2. And if it is 0.
It doesn't mean that it is stuck at S2. As long as you are getting 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, then you will be in S2 only.
Okay, sir.
Okay, that means you are not getting any valid sequence, no? So you have to be there only, because at any instant of time, the valid sequence may begin, no?
Okay, sir.
So you have to be there only. Your system should be there only, because it is expecting 110 to be detected. 1101.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Any more questions?
Sir, what happens if it is that n bit, maybe that is the last bit? It will, we don't like it. Sir, 111, sir, last example.
You mean this one?
That is the last bit.
If this is the last bit.
Yes, sir.
Last bit means your circuits will be in S2 only. Then you have to manually force into a reset state.
Okay, sir. Okay.
But normally, no, this kind of this action will happen in sequence over real time. I mean, continuously it will keep coming. If you are always getting 1-1 means no, your friend transmitter is sending you any data. That means you have to be in that state only till the time you are getting the valid sequence from any of your friend receiver. Understood? No.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay. Right, then we are moving into state table now. Right, we are moving into state table. State table means I am writing now present state and then input, present state and then input, then next state, then output, then output. Right, present state, input, present state, next state, output. Present state, next state, output. Right. The input means since this circuit input is x here, so x may be equal to 0 or that may be equal to 1. X may be equal to 0 or equal to 1 and up. Right. Because any input, that input that is coming into a circuit may be 0 or 1 and up. Right. Because this is a Miele circuit, the output also depends on the present as well as the input, then the output also will depend if x equal to 0 and x equal to 1. X equal to 0, x equal to 1, x equal to 0 and x equal to 1, input, x equal to 1. Right. The q plus will be always written as q plus next state, and this is the present state q. This is the present state q. So I am making one table, something like this. We are drafting one table. The same approach, there is no any deviation for any kind of sequential circuits. Fine. Right? So, if the present state is this one, present state is Q, next state is Q plus, right, next state is Q plus, then here also X equal to 0, and x equal to 1. X equal to 0, x equal to 1. X equal to 1. Then output also x equal to 0, x equal to 1. Then now, if the present state is S0, if the present state is S0, right, if x equal to 0, what is the, if x equal to 0, what is the next state?
S0.
S0 only.
S0.
Right? That means if the input is if x equal to 0, this one, if x equal to 0, 1 second. See, if x equal to 0, if x equal to 0, right, where does it go? It goes into S0. If x equal to 1, if x equal to 1, when we are in S0, where does it go?
S1.
What is the output when we are in S0? If the X is coming inside, what is output? 0. When X is 1, output is also 0. output is zero, right? Then, okay, both conditions we checked. Both conditions we checked. Put a tick mark. Next, if state is S1, so S0 may we have checked where we needed to go if x equal to 0 and x equal to 1 and x equal to 1 now, right? And then we checked the corresponding output also 0, 0. If it is in S1, if it is in S1 and x equal to 0, where does it will go?
S0.
X equal to 0, S0. X equal to 1, S2. Output is 0, 0. Output is 0, 0. If the present state is S2, where it will go? If x equal to 0?
S3.
S3. If x equal to 1?
S2.
S2.
S2. S2. S2. S2. We are staying there. S2. Outputs are 0, 0. Then in S3, if both inputs are applied, if x equal to 0, what happened?
S0. S0.
S0.
S0. S1.
And S1. 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 Outputs are?
0, 1.
1. 0, 1. Outputs are 0, 1 now. Close this one. Close this one now. This is what we call state transition table or state table. You can take state transition table. State transition table. So the first step is understanding the problem. Second step is drawing the state diagram. Third step is arriving the state transition table. Fourth step is state reduction algorithm, state reduction. Time being, I will stop the state deduction because here there is no need of any deduction here. We will continue in the subsequent example why it is required. Then the fifth step is excitation table. State excitation table. State excitation table. State excitation table. That means the state reduction will help you to optimize your states. Whether you really you need all these many states or you can reduce your number of states, right? There are implication algorithm. There are 3-4 algorithms are there. Merger diagram, implication table, permittive table, permittive flow control table. So there are some standard algorithms that we will see in the subsequent example. How to apply them for state reduction ke liye, right? So now directly we go into state excitation table. So this is our table. Do we have time? Next lecture is okay, right? We will continue then, maybe.